Hello everyone. Thinking is tough business. I mean, I'd rather think about easy things than hard things, wouldn't you? It's just a more pleasant experience and keeps me more relaxed. It turns out that there's a term for when we want to think about easy things coined by famous psychologist Daniel Kahneman called cognitive ease. Cognitive ease is exactly what it sounds like and is when our brain can process information simply, putting us at ease. Cognitive strain is the opposite and is when it takes effort for your brain to process information and puts you in strain. Kahneman argues that cognitive ease and cognitive strain help govern how we process the world around us, and the implications can be scary. Before we get into those implications though, let's first talk about some examples of cognitive ease. I've talked about the mirror exposure effect in a few of my other videos, but it's a good example of cognitive ease to start with. The mirror exposure effect is essentially the phenomenon that when you're repeatedly exposed to something, you're more likely to like it. This is why radio stations will play the same songs over and over again, because you'll be more likely to enjoy those songs later if you heard them a bunch of times. Robert Zajunc actually did an experiment where he put some made-up words in a student newspaper at the University of Michigan every single day for several weeks. He then asked the students, via questionnaires, what words they thought referred to something good and what words they thought referred to something bad. He found that the words that were used more in the papers were actually viewed to mean something more positive than words that were not used that much in the papers. The more students were exposed to certain words, the more positively they thought of those words. Our brains feel more at ease with things that are familiar to us, which could be one of the reasons why the effect occurs. Now, another example, if you were to see these two products in a grocery store, which one would you be more likely to buy? Probably the one on the left? Remember, our brains like taking the easiest route possible when it comes to processing information, and the label on the right just takes more brain power to understand that it says milk. So we choose the one on the left. Now, if I tried to explain something to you in greater detail than I usually do, like go into detail about published studies and talk about effect size, means, ANOVAs, p-values, etc., you'd probably tune out. It's cognitively straining to think about all of those things, and you'd much rather have me give you a simple explanation. Which brings me to why cognitive ease can be an issue because of what I like to call the lazy thinker problem. Humans find it unpleasant to think more than they have to, which leads them to find ways in which they don't have to think all that much. This can obviously lead to a lot of issues. Suppose a kid on the playground is bullied by his peers and is repeatedly being called a loser. This becomes a regular thing, and pretty soon it's easy for him to think about himself as being a loser instead of his victimhood under the social complexities of childhood harassment. This, among other factors, can lead to depression, which might require cognitive behavioral therapy to deal with these thoughts. It's easier for the kid to think about himself as a loser, since that's what everyone calls him, and it's an easier idea to grasp that maybe he doesn't talk to other people as much, other kids are jealous of his clothes, he has an unusual name, etc. Now, suppose you're going to the grocery store and want to buy some cereal. You want to change your diet a bit and buy more healthy cereal. Unfortunately, the healthy cereals do not have very appealing looking boxes and have weird brand names you are not familiar with. So instead of trying something new and potentially bad, judging on the look of the box, you get a more unhealthy option because it is more familiar to you and is easier to look at. A very topical issue with cognitive ease is when we get into politics and government in general. Governments are very complex organizations that are too often oversimplified. People oftentimes get frustrated with their governments and want things to move faster or change more. So, when campaign season starts, there are a lot of individuals out there that'll say things like, we can fix illegal immigration by just building a wall, or the rich are the cause of all our economic problems. While cognitive ease makes it simple for us to buy into these ideas, the reality is that they are a lot more complicated than they seem. But what we end up seeing is that people do not want to face those complexities because it is cognitively taxing and nobody wants to be in a state of cognitive strain. Eventually, these ideas become popular and familiar, and they become solid foundations of movements and parties. Not to get too extreme here, but I think it's important to mention that this is a main reason why cults are formed. There's a certain appeal to easy explanations for difficult problems, even if it's not a good explanation. Oh, your life isn't the way you want it, and you're wondering why? Well, it's because of this group of people and you should hate them. Or, have you ever wondered why you haven't found your life's purpose yet? It's because you haven't joined this group I'm in called ABC where we do XYZ. The lazy thinker problem is something I find myself contemplating more and more every day. There are so many people that can influence the way we think now with social media, the internet, and TV. Everyone is trying to provide simple solutions for not so simple problems, and it is causing people to not look at these problems more closely for themselves. Heck, I'm even trying to provide a simple explanation by labeling this as the lazy thinker problem and associating it with cognitive ease. Humans have amazing cognitive abilities, and while it's not always pleasant to put ourselves under strain from thinking so much, it's better than becoming numb to the danger of ease. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.